So today we will be covering a topic of how to remove text or an object or a content from an image. So basically I have taken few products and as well as few shoes where they are branded, and I want to remove them, the text or the branding logo, from that particular object. So why do we need to do this? So basically when you want to have a mock-up or you want to showcase a new brand or something like that, so they may ask you for your designs. So on such cases what we do is we try to take a dummy images or example images and try to design on top of them. So basically if you see here, I have two shoes over here. I'll start with the Nike shoe over here, but we are not any partner or anything of them. So just we are trying to utilize the brand logo over here. So what I'm doing is I'm just doing a selection part, you can understand that. So I'm using a magic wand over here. You can do it with any of the selection process, that doesn't matter. I was trying to, as it's having a same color, I thought magic wand will do. So I have selected this Nike symbol over here. So now I'm trying to remove the Nike symbol from this particular shoe image. So now first thing is, like, the pixel which we have selected, it's an and kind of thing, you can see over here. So first thing, I want to little bit expand the selection with a pixel of 3. So what happens is any missed pixel or little bit of white or anything as such will be removed. So now what I'm doing is I'm using shift backspace to fill. I'm using a continue awareness technique. Click OK. The Nike logo which is at present removed. So now I'm doing Control D. You can see we have done that. Now where and all the logo is there, we are trying to remove them out. So basically in the selection over here also you can remove it. There are two ways of doing. I don't mind just filling the color over here, so automatically it won't be a big or you can use a healing brush over here. So it's your wish actually. So based on the object which we are utilizing, so I'm using a spot healing brush over here. Just I'm trying to okay. So there are still little bit of patches here and there, but you get the basic point, right? So you can slowly do a small patch as such, automatically will be able to remove that. Then the remaining small parts, okay, this is done. So there is a Nike symbol over here also, I don't want to use it, so this particular part is sufficient. So here is another part. Okay, so all we are using is a spot healing brush over here. So now you have a just mock-up, you can use them as a mock-up, and this you can utilize on the background or somewhere you want to use. So I'm taking a second shoe pair. So each and every product or each and every object has a different scenarios. So here I'm using a selection, okay, I'm using a quick selection over here. I'm selecting the object over here, that is the image. Okay, so be careful when you have a two tone as such, or two colors like white and as well as orange, you have to be careful. Okay, so you are able to part. But as I told you, we can't exactly select the pixel, so we are having a little bit expansion with 3 pixels. So what happens, this is your selection, 3 pixels on top of that we are taking as complete. So control back space, we'll be getting content field. So here using content awareness, and you will be able to do that. Okay, the same way the other shoe, let's quickly do it. Okay, and as we are content filling it and expanding as well, so you need not do the exact part, so approximation also will do. So we are using content backspace, shift backspace, sorry. Here we are using content awareness, we have removed this also. So the logos of the brand are removed. Well, still there are a few parts over here with the text. So what I am going to do is, I am going to take a brush, Alt 2, pick the color. Here as well, I'll pick the color from here, remove all of the text, done. You have 2 mockups right now which you can utilize, and the third one, when you are going for your bottle, I just want this sample of the bottle, I don't want anything else. Okay, so I just want to take this particular bottle right now. So basically what I'll do is, I'll do the quick selection again in the same way. Okay, here we don't do that expansion actually, so we want exactly the shape of this particular bottle we are looking for. So what we can do, you can use the pen tool, which will be easier over here because there are no much curves or anything. So I'm using a pen tool over here. Okay, just a small curve. As possible on the shape of the bottle. So until here I can click on the settings. So yeah, so next a small curve again, I can click over here, there is a curve actually, you can see that. Okay, so let me zoom a little bit. So you can utilize this zooming, zoom back and zoom in, so you will exactly know what to do with these things. So I'm using Alt to press to remove the extra head over here. So okay, here also I'm removing the heads. So here a little bit I'm removing the head over here, so totally. Okay, until here. Okay, again a small curve. I'm using the pen tool, hoping that you guys know how to use the pen tool. If you don't know how to use the pen tool, okay, I'll leave a tutorial of using pen tool in the description as soon as possible. Otherwise you can comment that you require a tutorial on how to use the pen tool, I can make a separate tutorial for you guys. Now right click, make selection, feather 0.5. okay, as I require exact shape of the bottle, I'm not going to increase. So now I'll just select and erase it out. So here, so this is the thing, so something like this. I'm selecting over here, just I'm using a magic wand over here. Okay, I'm using shift button to select extra elements. Okay, hope I have selected everything over here. So what I'll do, just you remember the expansion part, right? So come to modify, expand, instead of 3 pixels I'll use 2. Okay, now shift backspace content awareness, done. So you have clean bottle with the shape of it. Okay, if I have to use this somewhere, I can use this. Let me take spotting healing brush. Wherever you see these extra marks, you can use spot healing brush over here. You require a little bit patience of doing as such, but the outcome which you are expecting will be surely good. So as I'm just showing an example, I'm taking this particular piece. So now I want to show this particular product and display in various backgrounds. So I told you why we require removal and mockups. So this is why it is. So I have selected a few of the backgrounds to show you how stylish it will be on the various backgrounds. I made them onto an A4 size sheet. So just I want to highlight you with various images how you will be feeling the product. This is how you showcase your product. So first, immediately whenever you are trying to do, okay, you try to have as many backgrounds as possible before, then remove the text on the product and use the backgrounds to identify which one is showing more appealing, and then you can present it to the client or someone you are working for. So if they and you are feeling the same, then you can take ahead and start design on top of that. Okay, most of you will be, you can be utilizing these kind of things on the e-commerce portals. Okay, so just I want to show you, let me take this product as well. I'm not going to do much actions, just I'll try to take as much as possible. Please control J. So I have selected only this image part. I'm taking this, bringing that to here. I'm turning off the shoes, taking this product. Okay, usually let me try to do something about this background. So I'm using a masking tool over here, control I to invert this particular thing. Now I use a small brush over here, done. I have a small reflection over here, just I want to if I require I'll utilize this, otherwise I will be removing this part as well. For now let me remove, because it is not a glass part, so you may feel it as negative. I'll do one thing, should say. So I have much more control how to erase them. Okay, light shadow. You may feel as a product is, you have product. Now let me show you with the different background images. So hope you understood how to remove text or image from can be image, but you will be able to do this. Hope you like it. If you like it, please give us a like and subscribe. Thank you.